Last Friday, the Pentagon announced that Secretary of Defense Lloyd Austin had been hospitalized. But there's a big catch. Austin wasn't hospitalized that day. In fact, he was hospitalized on Monday of that week. Obviously, the general public didn't know that until recently. And what's even more concerning is that Joe Biden and the Biden administration were also in the dark about Lloyd Austin's condition. He was in the intensive care unit, which seems like something they should have been aware of as it was happening. Now, let's get to the timeline of events and then discuss the fallout, including some of the most laughable statements I've heard from reporters on this matter. So on December 22nd, Austin underwent some sort of elective medical procedure. We don't know the details about it. I don't think that he should have to disclose what it is, but he should have been disclosing what happened next. So on Monday, January 1st, he was placed in Walter Reed's intensive care unit after experiencing severe pain related to complications from said procedure. Now on Tuesday, January 2nd, Kathleen Hicks, who's the Deputy Secretary of Defense, basically took over Lloyd Austin's role. She assumed his duties. And she was not informed about what happened to Austin, and that's according to two defense officials who spoke to CNN. Now on Thursday, January 4th, the President, White House, and Hicks are finally all informed of Austin's hospitalization. And Friday, January 5th, was when the Pentagon finally announced to the general public what the situation was. Now, Austin released the following statement on January 6th, quote, "I'm very glad to be on the mend and look forward to returning to the Pentagon soon. I also understand the media concerns about transparency, and I recognize I could have done a better job ensuring the public was appropriately informed. I commit to doing better, but this is important to say. This was my medical procedure and I take full responsibility for my decisions about disclosure." And look, to be clear, I don't really care about him having to inform the general public about it, but I do think it's incredibly important for Biden to know about it in the very least, and for Biden administration officials to be aware that Lloyd Austin was in the ICU. The Pentagon's press secretary has also offered the following weak excuse in regard to Austin's status not being disclosed. Pentagon Press Secretary Major General Patrick Ryder told the Times that because Austin's chief of staff, Kelly Magsiman, was ill, she was unable to make notifications until Thursday. She was sick. So she couldn't let the general public know about what was going on. At the time, General Ryder said Magsiman was notified Kathleen Hicks, the deputy defense secretary, and Jake Sullivan, President Biden's national security advisor, about Austin's hospitalization. And Austin has resumed duties, but he remains hospitalized according to the Pentagon. So before we get to some of the most ridiculous media statements about this, Cenk, what do you think? Like, do you think that people are overreacting about Biden being in the dark about this?
Yes, definitely.
Interesting. Why?
Okay, so three reasons why. Number one, his deputy took over the very next day. Should have been instant. That's a slight problem. That's a real problem, right? But once the deputy took over, who cares? They have the same exact policy. They talked to Biden in the same exact way. Not like it wasn't like, oh my God, we're in the middle of a war, and he let the he didn't get orders to the commanders in the field. No, yeah, Israel and Ukraine are happening now, but nothing urgent happened that the deputy couldn't handle, right? So that's point one. Point two is, look, it's hard for me to take stories like this seriously on two fronts. So I don't know what you'll think about one, but I know you'll agree with the other. So one is like, oh my God, it's such a travesty, such a big deal. After Trump, nothing's a big deal. I mean, Trump has done the craziest things. Like, his defense secretaries were acting secretaries. He had ordered them to bring out the tanks against the American people. They wouldn't do it. Now that's an outrage, bringing the tanks against martial law against the American people. That's the other dude went to the hospital and his deputy took over. Wow. So that that's my honest assessment. Okay, now the other part is all the reporters saying this, it's hard to trust the Pentagon after
okay,
this. Oh, come on, guys. You like, this is the first lie from the Pentagon, and you're all reporters covering the Pentagon? This is like the smallest lie the Pentagon has ever said.
Yeah, look, I think him ending up in the ICU is something that Biden should have known about immediately.
Sure, I do, in an ideal world, for sure,
yeah,
yes.
But look, do I think it's the most egregious thing that's happened in government? No, I don't. But obviously, the communication should be enhanced to the as much as they possibly can, because Biden being in the dark about this is a problem. Now, what amazes me, though, is it appears that Biden is more. He said something along the lines of, if Lloyd Austin tried to resign over this, I wouldn't accept his resignation, right? Mm-hmm. So it seems like Biden's giving him a pass. The people who are more angry with Lloyd Austin happen to be the reporters. And this is where I can't help but laugh at the figures involved. So let's start off with CNN Pentagon correspondent Barbara Starr, who was absolutely furious about being left in the dark about this. Mm-hmm. As of tonight, I do not see a way forward for believing the Pentagon tells the truth on anything. Barbara, 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 are you serious right now? This is the first time where you're like, oh, maybe I should be skeptical of what the Pentagon tells me. Yeah, that's the ticket. What?
No, I know.
This is why they get hired, guys. This is why they get hired.
No, as I read through all those reporters with their faux outrage, I was like, really? Like, it didn't bother you when the Pentagon said we didn't bomb a wedding in Afghanistan, it turned out we had and killed like 86 people? It didn't bother you when the Pentagon said that we didn't kill American citizens abroad, but it turned out we had through drone strikes, etc. But you're worried that they hurt your feelings by not reporting this on time?
Barbara.
This is the first time it's occurred to you that the Pentagon might not be telling the truth?
Barbara, come on, Barbara.
Yeah.
It's so depressing. Okay, so that's Barbara. But there's more. For instance, when it comes to Fox News, well, one of their reporters, Jennifer Griffin, was also furious and made some comparisons to another country. Chief National Security Correspondent for Fox News, Jennifer Griffin, said it's the type of behavior you expect from the Chinese government.
Really?
Is it?
I mean,
is it?
Are the Chinese notorious for misreporting or underreporting hospital stays? I mean, I know there's a lot of critiques of the Chinese government. I didn't know that was one of them. Anyways, look, guys, if they were this outraged about other things that the Pentagon has done wrong, then I say, great, way to be vigilant, right? Because they should have reported it right away, especially to the president, right? But they're making this seem like the biggest federal case when they've let 100 things, 10,000 times more egregious, slide by
100%.
With barely a comment. So that's why this whole thing seems hilarious to me. But look, we're always fair. So I am a little curious why Biden didn't notice that the deputy was reporting into him instead of the defense secretary. And for Biden, a lot of things are personal. And so Lloyd Austin served with Bo Biden. And they used to go to church together, right? So he really loves Lloyd Austin. So he could have done 1,000 things wrong and he would have let it slide because they're pals. I don't think that's really how the government should work, but it does often. Biden's not the first one. But at the end of all of this, I come back to, yeah, but remember that Trump wouldn't even read the presidential daily briefings. Right, like unless it had his name or pictures on it. George W. Bush said about the presidential daily briefing that bin Laden was determined to attack inside the US. You covered your ass, go home, and did nothing about it for a month. So all these presidents, it's shocking and sad how clueless they are. Mm-hmm. So Biden, by comparison, is actually way better than the guys I just mentioned. So that's why I'm a little bit more willing to give him a pass on this one.
In the bonus episode for our members today, I would like to speculate on what the elective surgery was. Because I think elective surgery and I think like, I don't know, nose job. You know, that's not what he did, I'm sure. But like, let's talk about it, let's speculate, let's have fun.
Okay, it'll be fun, it'll be totally like
unacceptable and inappropriate.
Totally, yep. I denounce and reject this ahead of time, preemptively. Okay, so check it out at tyt.com/join. Or if you're on YouTube, hit the join button.
And no judgment when it comes to nose jobs.
If you enjoy this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.